magnetometer location, or the problems that can arise with the wrong location. So show you the panel here, where we are. We're looking underneath the thigh support on the long easy, and this one down here is the location I chose for my magnetometer. It's been working great, to tell you the truth. Haven't had many issues until I put in this landing light, and still is working good. But the other day, for the first time, I started using the landing light. I'll show you how. You just pull this lever and you can lower the landing light into this airstream, and then turn it on or off. But what I want to show you is that, you know, since I never used the landing light very much before, I never noticed this issue. So as you can see, the heading is 234 right now, and first thing we're going to do is turn on the landing light with it retracted. So landing light is on the ammo cycle, as you can see the landing light is on, and let's look at the effect that it has on the heading. You can see the heading is, it was 234, now it's moving. It's the same as if I was making a slow left turn right there. So it's about 230, looks like it's getting into the 229. Let's go to 230. So what happens when I drop the landing light into the airstream? We're gonna do that right now. Let's keep looking. You can see there is more left turn to be had. Of course, we're not moving. And what that creates is, on final, I get these crazy looking winds. They're just indicated winds right here of like 50 knots on final. While I'm pointing straight at the airport right there, I can see my runway is over here to the left, and my flight path is over to the left, like I'm still going to it, but it all appears like I got like a 30 knot crosswind, where in effect there is nothing. So I'm gonna turn that switch off now. All right, light is off. Take another quick look at what's happening to the heading. See, it's coming back to where it was 234, 235, something like that. And so one of the issues it might be, as you can see, there's a, let's see, these white wires. Let me close this up that we don't get any extra weird light. This white wire is what is powering the light, and it's really, really close to the magnetometer. So first thing I'm gonna do is try to move these wires over to that side and see if we still have a problem. And if the problem persists, then I'm gonna have no other thing left to do but just move this magnetometer probably inside the wing, inside the wing root there, between right there. Between the strake, this is the strake, and the wing, there's like a little hole inside there where I'm gonna put the ADSB, and I might end up putting that as well. So that's the latest update. That's what we're gonna be working on right now. Well, this is a good example of the kind of stuff you don't want to find out when you start digging into the electrical system. And the original builder told me he didn't do this, so one of the previous owner must have had some work done by some mechanic, and this is what they came up with. And needless to say, they had to go. Fast forward a month and a half, I have moved all the wires that were going on near the magnetometer. Magnetometer was down here, so there were like five wires. Four routed this way now, the other one is routed that way. There are no wires near the magnetometer now. So landing light is down. We're gonna try to turn the landing light on. And actually, that was already on. Turn the light on. Let's see, on and off. off again, on again, no change whatsoever in the heading right there, 059. Light is still on. We're gonna try to retract it, see if it makes a difference in the heading. Not. Turn the light off again. No changes whatsoever. So I'm extremely pleased. That's exactly what we want to see. Good. And just show you, that's the new panel. I haven't screwed it in yet, but it's completed.